Drake, and he is the company commander for the 42nd Airborne Company. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to present to you the members of the Command Expedition Parachute Team, Mr. Morgan.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Third and five. Thank you. Alex Black and Joe.
Thank you.
Carter, Trojan Neck, 24, Federal 3.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Back on the field with Tennessee football coach Johnny Majors after the 24-all tie with Army. Coach Majors, I guess the first thing, compliment Army on just an outstanding effort.
Well, Bob, they did a superb job. They did a superb job last week. Their team executed extremely well. They're well-disciplined. They fight awfully, awfully hard. They didn't make many mistakes. We caused a couple, I guess, in the ball game and got one fumble back on them. So I have a great amount of respect for what they've done, period. And also, our defense failed to wake up or show up for the first half. We couldn't get the ball enough to do anything effective enough over a period of time. When we got the ball on offense, we moved the ball and scored and made a great drive in the last minute and 15 seconds to tie the game at halftime. Did some good things in the third quarter. The fourth quarter, our defense finally waked up and decided to do some play in the second half. We made a few adjustments. And then our offense bogged down at very critical times in the fourth quarter and did not make first downs on a couple occasions. Give my hats off to Army. They did a terrific job. And the only good thing about it was not a defeat.
What about Darryl Dickey, his performance in his first start?
I thought he played awfully well. I think if everybody had performed as well as Darryl did in his initial start or in their whatever starts they were, we'd have won the ball game. I was very pleased with his start, his leadership, and his handling of the football team.
Army drove the length of the field to tie the game at 24. Tennessee moved the ball back to midfield. It was 4th and 4. What was the thinking on the play, and what were the options, and what were you talking about on the sidelines?
In the last few seconds, or 35 seconds to go?
Last play.
I felt like we had to play to win in that situation. If we would have been playing for a championship, which we're not ready to play for at this stage for sure, we'd been playing for a championship and a tie would have handled it, well, I might have done it. But that time, I felt like we had to play for the win, and on our home field, and a favorite like we were, baloney. I'm going to go for it in that situation normally.
And Darryl Dickey really delivered. He had the ball right on target.
Yeah, we had one receiver drop. We had 3 drop passes in a game that were bad. Unfortunately, one of them we overcame and went on in to score our last touchdown, but 2 other drop passes on the last possessions were critical in the ball game.
Long drives were the key in the game. Both teams moved the ball up and down the field.
Well, Army moved it way too much, and we better do a tremendous job in bucking up and sucking it up and doing a lot of adjustments and playing a lot harder on defense next week, or we'll wake up at halftime and we'll be out of the ball game. We made some good drives. I was very disappointed our defense let the Army offense stay on the football field too that blame long.
Coach Majors, next week you go up against Auburn, a team that also runs the wishbone. An advantage playing a team like Army this week, or any major adjustments you ought to make to go up against Army's wishbone?
I'd say that we've got a lot of work to do between now and the Auburn game. I'd say that right now I'm not ready to comment on whether there's any advantages or disadvantages. If things do go well, I'd say it's probably a swap-at deal where you get some chance to look at the wishbone and the opponents also get a chance to look at the way you try to prepare for them. Today, I hope that we can get a lot better from today. If we don't, we'll have a hard time regardless whether they see us or not.
Coach Majors, thanks for your time. See you in Auburn next week.
Thank you, Bob.
Thanks to Coach Johnny Majors. Today, Tennessee ties Army 24-24 here at Neyland Stadium. We'll be back in the locker room to talk with members of the Volunteers in just a moment. In the Tennessee locker room, visiting with members of the Volunteers after the tie with Army 24-all. This is Darryl Dickey, who made his first start at quarterback for the Volunteers in the game. Darryl, I know a disappointing game, but you have to be excited with the way you played. You performed pretty well offensively.
Well, Bob, we did some good things. We got a ways to go. We got to start doing some things in the fourth quarter. We've been lucky 2 games before not to been in any worse record than we got now because of the fourth quarter, and today it caught up with us. We got to improve our execution in that quarter and keep building on the positive things we did today. We did some things well, but we got to build the fourth quarter, and that's definitely an area that's very vital in college football today, and it's something that we just have to improve.
Army kept the ball away from you, though, in the first half. You couldn't do much offensively.
Yeah, that's one thing with the wishbone offense. They have a tendency to keep moving the ball and slow 3-yard gains all the time, and they did keep the ball away from us. I think we had the ball 3 times in the first half, and 1 time was with 1:30 left in the half. And, I think we were fortunate to come out with 10 points.
Evaluate your performance for us. How do you think you did?
Well, Bob, I think for the first game, I executed some things well, but like I say, we need to build the fourth quarter. And I wasn't sharp enough in the fourth quarter. We had some incomplete passes, especially when it came right down to it, down on the wire. We still had some incomplete passes that need to be sharpened up. And, we're fortunate to come out with a tie. And we'll have to build on the positive things and suck it up and get better. We got a heck of a schedule coming up. And we just got to build on what we did positive and keep our heads up and keep going.
Now talking with Tommy Sims, UT defensive back. Tommy, the Army wishbone, very effective and very consistent. Were you surprised by how efficiently they ran it?
Yes, in the first half they came out and they stuck the ball right down our throat. We were surprised by the execution, how well they went about running the option game. And they gave us problems with the out patterns and getting on the corners, forcing play on the outside.
They really didn't make many mistakes, did they?
No, they were very fundamentally sound, and they were fighters. And that made it tough for us because they kept coming at us four quarters straight.
What about in the fourth period when you finally started to stop them, but the offense couldn't move the ball for them?
Well, we stressed all week on improving in the fourth quarter, and we had two good defensive stands in first of the fourth quarter. But then we let up like in the last 5 minutes of the fourth quarter, and they drove the ball again. We gave up a touchdown. So we just got to go back and work hard and get better in defending our goal in the fourth quarter.
One of the big defensive plays for the Volunteers, interception by Vince Clark that stopped an Army drive. Vince, congratulations on the interception, but I know you had to be a little disappointed on the outcome of today's game.
Yeah, you know, anytime that we don't win, you know, a game, you know, there's a little disappointment there. But, you know, it's hard to really say what the problem was or what went wrong, you know, until we watch films tomorrow, Sunday afternoon. You know, as far as I'm concerned, I get ready. I'm ready to play my position, and I couldn't really say what was wrong with the guys there or if there was anything wrong at all. But the loss, you know, or the tie, rather, is, you know, it's not something that you very happy about.
At the free safety position, I know that even then the wishbone puts a lot of pressure on you to have to watch for the pass, and Army really did some things well offensively, didn't they?
Yes, but most of the time, they had me playing a two-deep scheme here, you know. Rather, sometimes I'm more inclined to have a run responsibility to the left, a run responsibility to the right. But this game, it was more, I was a true safety man. I was simply playing two-deep coverage on the half and waiting for the pass to come. And that's what, you know.
I got to gear up for Auburn next week, another big game.
Yes. Hopefully we can get some things ironed out here, and I'm sure that we will. You know, with the coaching staff and the players we have, I'm sure we can bounce back.
This is Todd Upton from Alcoa, offensive guard of the Volunteers. Todd, give us a rundown on the Tennessee offense and your thoughts.
Well, we started out the game pretty good. We drove the ball down the field and did some things that hurt them. And then second half, we started doing the same things. And then at fourth quarter, they did some things that kind of slowed us down.
Just some mistakes on Tennessee again really slowed you down again.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I guess it was a situation where you had a chance to win the game again but just didn't execute properly in the fourth period.
Yes, sir. That's what it, basically what happened.
Now you got to regroup a little bit for Auburn?
Definitely. Most definitely.
So that's a word from Tennessee's locker room after the Volunteers tie with the Army Cadets 24-all. Next week, the Volunteers travel to Auburn. John Ward will be back to wrap things up in just a moment.